for those of you that escape cults, what was your I need to get the fuck out story? Not me, my mother. She used to go to a church college up in New Jersey. Not gonna name any names here, but a cult nonetheless. No music, aside from Christian radio, strict dress codes, etc. She knew they were bad, but she realized she needed to GTFO when the preacher went up to the podium and mentioned offhand that while wrong, Jim Jones had a good point. This was in the 80s, mind you. Right after Jonestown, churches fused with colleges are fucking death traps for college freshmen. My cousin and I talking on the phone when we were 16 and he had just gotten diagnosed with cancer. We were Jehovah's Witnesses and they don't allow blood transfusions. To live, Trent was going to need blood transfusions. I can still hear him saying, I don't want to piss off Jehovah but I don't want to die. I'm just a kid, quote. And all at once I went from being a good little JW kid to only doing what I absolutely had to. Because I still lived with my parents. What did your cousin decide to do? Not die. My grandmother, on the other hand, died from refusing blood. Two instances stick out to me. Although I was just a child, my family was very involved and we didn't get out until I was a teenager. My mom is still a member. 1. My first time sitting in a crowded room while the elders or leaders of the group publicly announced someone being disfellowshipped or excommunicated, meaning they did something wrong and nobody was allowed to speak to them until they were reinstated. I just remember feeling so sick for the monsieur. They were publicly shamed and humiliated, and their family was also treated poorly usually. Everyone knew about their perceived wrongdoings. Even as a little kid it just seemed so wrong to me. Shouldn't we have been extra supportive and loving to people when they were struggling with bad choices? Shouldn't we be encouraging? It felt so gross and cruel. I knew then something was wrong but I was only about 5 years old and if you questioned anything it meant Satan was putting lies into your head so I always just kept my mouth shut. If you tried to get out you'd be shunned too and lose everyone you love. 2. When I was 8 years old, struggling with my parents' divorce and my dad's subsequent exit from the congregation, and an older family member sat me down and told me that if I wanted to have a dad I needed to convince him to start going back to meetings and being a good member of the congregation. Otherwise he would die at Armageddon and I'd never see him again. What a fucked up thing to tell a child. These are just the two biggest instances that come to mind, but I have a whole lifetime of trauma from my years in the cult. All the stuff they teach you as a kid really fucks with you. Shunning people and constantly having nightmares about Armageddon really messed with me as a kid. It's pretty fucking traumatizing. I used to be in a group called the Grand Old Party, but after watching the leader brag about sexually assaulting women, insult fallen members of the military, pointlessly repeal protections for the environment, push xenophobic policies, engage in every petty dispute available, continually praise dictator despots, spend his work hours pushing baseless conspiracy theories, and attempt to scale back testing during a worldwide pandemic, I began to subtly think that I may be a part of a cult with a death drive and a leader intent on driving the entire group straight over a cliff. I was reading like I mouth I and then I googled the name and realized it was Trump LMAO. Went to a church that had a night where a faith healer came to visit. He healed a teenager of very severe asthma. As a sign of his faith, the teenager goes out on the bike trails without his inhaler the next day and almost dies. The pastor visits the family in the hospital and tells the heartbroken parents it was because they didn't have enough faith, and with that, I exit stage right. I say that because that's when I realized the whole thing was an effing show. Former Jehovah Witness. The way they treat people who aren't in the religion and also how they treat people who do get excommunicated reminds me of a life hack. If a Jehovah's Witness comes to your door, say you've been excommunicated and see how fast they GTFO up there. I am an excommunicated JW. That means I was never baptized, so they were allowed to talk preach to me still, and my parents would send them to my door constantly. I told my husband at the time that if they came to the door to tell them we were disfellowshipped, and they would go away. So the next time they stopped by, I sent him to the door. But in his confusion and misunderstanding, he told them we were dismembered and can't talk right now. I had hoped by the look on their faces that that would keep them away, but they are persistent buggers. It's a funny memory though. Not excommunicated. They call it disfellowshipped. You really want to mess with them, tell them you're an apostate. Someone who was once a JW but left. That's like 10x worse. Former Mormon. And when I was about 13 and couldn't get any satisfying explanation as to why women couldn't hold the priesthood, i.e., have any position in the church above a Sunday school teacher, everything we learned and did revolved around becoming a good housewife. He knocked on my closed bedroom door when he heard me on the phone and said, "Get off the phone. Lights out." It was 10 p.m. on a Saturday and I'm 25. How did I let myself become a piece of property to these people? I was used as whatever role they wanted me to fill. TBH. I'm just kinda fucked up, RN. My therapist said that I was in a cult. I was too closely tied to a married couple double my age. I lived in their house. I was groomed to take drugs, do sex. I watched their kid and he eventually called me sister. They took advantage of me losing my family at 17. 2 years later, I find myself involved in a crazy drug orgy every 3 months by people who I considered my saviors, my real family. I have a hard time talking about it in therapy to my boyfriend and my new family. I'm happy I got out of it. PTSD moment. Dang. You guys, I feel not good for posting this here because maybe it doesn't count. Asterisk, I'm recovering from surgery. Sorry for the drunk tone, asterisk. This definitely counts. Most cults are massive. They're small so that the leaders of the group can maintain control. I am a former Jehovah's Witness. It was a lot of things. But a big one was that I never felt like I could do enough. It was constant, never-ending guilt. I used to think there was a problem with me. But I finally realized that no matter how much I did, I would still feel like I wasn't doing enough. And that this wasn't an accident. They wanted you to feel guilty and inadequate. I reached a breaking point and knew I had to get out for my own well-being. Now I know more about cults and realize that this is a cornerstone of cult manipulation. My morning runs take me through a local park, and at one of the entrances to the park, teenage Jehovah's Witnesses often sit with a big sign handing out brochures. The sign, literally, says, "Will this suffering ever end?" Seeing the two miserable kids sitting next to it, I gotta hope so. I'm wondering if you can do anything for them, or maybe once take some time out of your run-in. Actually talk to them about how they feel about the whole suffering thing. Teenagers are prone to influencing. Maybe there is a way to show them how they can make their own life better. Probably by leaving the JWs. But also, by taking responsibility for themselves and actively making their environment a better place. I know it's not my duty to tell you what to do during your runs. But I'd like to think that there is hope for these kids. It's not something I'd ever considered doing before. But while I won't pretend I'm optimistic about it, I will consider doing so next time I see them. You're right that I shouldn't see them just as people who are suffering outside my circle when I am capable of being the one to reach out. You are a more compassionate person than I am. And I'm glad there are people like you in the world. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.